In this video, we will be talking about propellers and how you can select the right propeller for your particular drone. So this here is a propeller. Propellers are designed to spin in particular direction, either clockwise or counterclockwise. This is because, as I mentioned in the previous video, motors on the drone are also spinning in a certain direction. That is, two motors spin in counterclockwise, like this one and this one, and two of them spin in clockwise, like this one and this one. So therefore, we will be needing these propellers to be spinning in that particular direction. So how to identify whether the propeller is designed to spin in clockwise or counterclockwise? So for that, you have to look at this particular blade of the propeller and see and look at its leading edge. So the top blade is the leading edge. So therefore, this propeller will be spinning in clockwise direction. So similarly, you can identify a counterclockwise direct propeller. So this one here is a counterclockwise and this is a clockwise. So propellers are available in different sizes. Depending on your application, you will be selecting the size of the propeller. So for a racing drone, it is standard to use a 5-inch propeller. For indoor applications, you might want something like this or a 3-inch prop like this one. And for bigger applications such as a high payload carrying drone, you'll need something like this. So this is a carbon fiber propeller which is of 11 inches. So what do I mean when I say this particular propeller is of 5-inch size? So it is the size of the propeller makes when it is spinning. So it makes a disc shape and the diameter of that disc is 5 inches. The next attribute we will be looking at is the pitch of the propeller. So pitch basically is the angle of these blades. So as you can see, these blades are at a particular angle. So this is basically the pitch. The definition of pitch is the distance a propeller can travel in one complete rotation. So how can you identify the size of propeller and its pitch? So you just have to look at particular numbers. So there are a few numbers mentioned on the propeller, like this one here. Let me try to focus. So this says 50-48. And I have another one here which says 50-43. So the first two digits, that is 50, is the size, that is 5.0 inches, and the second two digits, that is 43 in this case, it is 4.3 inches. Therefore, this particular propeller will travel 4.3 inches in one complete rotation. A bigger propeller, whether in size or pitch, is usually heavier and hence requires more current to be spun. Therefore, a motor with a bigger pitch propeller or a bigger length propeller will produce more thrust, but it will also draw more current, which will drain a bit of its battery life. So let us look at a different type of propeller that I have here. So this is called as a bullnose propeller. So it is called as bullnose because the tip of it is flat. So as you can see, this tip is flat as compared to this one. So this is a pointed tip. Therefore, it has a slightly more surface area as compared to this one. And since it has more surface area, it will tend to produce slightly more thrust. Let us talk about the number of blades on a propeller. These are 3-bladed propellers, while this one is a 2-bladed. So since we were talking about surface area a moment ago, so having more blades on a propeller means it will obviously have more surface area. Therefore, it will produce more thrust, but it will also be heavier and draw more current. More bladed propeller usually has better grip on the air. More blades you add on a propeller, heavier it gets, and therefore it slowly starts becoming inefficient. Usually we stop at 2 or 3-bladed propellers. Maximum you can use are 4-bladed propellers, and more than that, they start becoming inefficient. So how can you select the particular propeller for your drone? When you look at the spec sheet of the motors, you will find a particular number mentioned there. So that number that we just looked at is the propeller size. From here, you can usually select the propeller, or you can also look at your frame, like this one here. This frame only supports 5-inch props. So as you can see, from here to here, only a 5-inch prop can fit. If I wanted to fit a 6-inch propeller, I couldn't do it because it would just hit the frame. So this is another method how you can determine the maximum size of propeller you can use. Let's see what type of materials you can use to make a propeller. So these ones here are made up of plastic. So this is a type of flexible plastic, so even if it hits something, it will just bend and you can bend it back to its original shape. In bigger drones, you tend to use a propeller like this one. So this is carbon fiber, so it's strong and lightweight. It is usually recommended not to use plastic propellers like this in a bigger drone, because the torque it produces can actually bend the prop while it's spinning. So you can see this one bends quite a bit, quite a bunch as compared to this carbon fiber. So this one doesn't bend much and it is quite stiff. And it is also possible to use any stiff material, maybe you can also use wood or aluminium. But carbon fiber, since it is both strong and lightweight, finds more use than aluminium and wood. So that is it about propellers. In the next video, we will be talking about ESCs, that is electronic speed controllers.